come here, my pretty dear. Leave business, care, and labour. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. My merry pipe and tabor, my merry pipe and tabor. I see all sorts of curious wares, tapes, garters, ribbons, laces, that give the form enchanting airs and set off pretty faces. And then I filters drugs and charms that when the nymph's deserted shall lure the shepherd to our arms and make him tender-hearted, and make him tender-hearted. Come here, my pretty dear, leave business, care, and labour. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. My merry pipe and tabor, my merry pipe and tabor. This wonderful of powder sea, though ever so hard-featured, to a Venus that converts each e by making her good-natured. This high water can power dispense to cure his jealous blindness and turn to generous confidence each jarring strife to kindness, each jarring strife to kindness. Come here, my pretty dear, leave business, care, and labour. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. My merry pipe and tabor, my merry pipe and tabor. When clad shall wedlock's skyey face and dim that brilliant heaven, upon your lips this padlock place by wary prudence given. But when from storms and tempest free the horizon looks propitious, from kindness and take pleasure's key, an open scene's delicious, an open scene's delicious. Come here, my pretty dear, leave business, care, and labour. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Christmas comes but once a year. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. Come, lads and lasses, come and hear. My merry pipe and tabor, my merry pipe and tabor.
Well, but Stingo, said the Baronet, did you take care to execute all those orders I gave you?
Oh, yes, Your Honor, said Stingo. I told the Morris dancers not to fail, and I have got a rare fellow with a barrel organ, and Your Honor's own company of fencibles with their military band be to be drawn up upon the lawn, and then there is to be cricket, quoits, and prison bars in the paddock, the maids to be play at puss-puss in the shrubbery and to run for smocks on the upland. And then I had gotten such a stage for single stick, it would do your heart good to have your head broke upon it. Oh, but I had like to have forgot one thing. I called upon Lawyer Lambskin, as Your Honour ordered me, so I had a mind to have a bit of fun with the lawyer. I had a mortal hankering to see the marriage settlements, but first I altered a word. 'Twas only the rough draft, you see. So he tells Tom, the clerk, to read. Tom begins, No one woman buy these presents. What, said old lambskin, squeezing his barnacles upon his nose. You should say no all men buy these presents. Why, Lord, said I, Master Lambskin, it be much the same thing. If one woman do know it, all the men will know it presently. Well said, Stingo, said the Commodore, who now came up with a bevy of beauties. And well said, sir, said Stingo. If your honour goes to that, ecod, you seafaring gentlemen have always an eye to the pretty girls. An eye to 'em and a heart for 'em, you lubber. I obey them as the prow obeys the helm. Was that you say about a crow upon an elm? I do like to hear his fine sea lingo. They belay our hearts as snug as an anchor fish to the cat. Well, then, that is snug enough, for it is no easy matter to get fish away from a cat. What are you jabbering about, you swab? I tell you, they'll bring us all to two. Oh, ecod, when your daughter be married to my young master, I do hope she'll bring him more than two. I should like to see a whole house full of pretty creatures. This misconception of poor Stingo set all the company into a laugh. When, finding the Commodore in uncommon spirits, they prevailed on him to sing a favourite song of his own writing.